Leviticus 27, verse 30. I'll give you a second to get there. And then it goes on to say, a tithe of everything from the land, whether grain from the soil or fruit from the trees, belongs to the Lord. It is holy to the Lord. Amen? But they thought of everything. The Lord thought of everything as he laid out the prescriptions of where, how, when he wanted the tithe to be brought. Isn't that interesting? So I think this particular tithe has some great meaning. Looking down at verse 33, let's look at 32 again. The entire tithe of the herd and flock, every tenth animal that passes under the shepherd's rod will be holy to the Lord. Can't be more clear than that. Holy to the Lord means it's devoted. The word devoted can also mean cursed. Means it's devoted to God, but cursed if you eat it for yourself. Is that right to say that? I get the question all the time. People say, if Jesus died on the cross for us, and we're redeemed from the curse of the law, how can we still have problems if we don't tithe, or how can any dimension of curse operate in our lives? Well, it's actually very, very simple. So how is it simple? Well, Jesus died for everybody in the world, every sin, every possibility of defeat that you could ever have. Is that right? But everybody does not receive that sacrifice by repentance and faith. So you can't say, hey, Jesus died for every curse. I'm not going to be under any kind of curse that's upon me for nonconformance with a tithe, because that's just an Old Testament and Jesus died. No. No, Jesus is meant, if you repent and move in rebellion, he will take the penalty for your sin. But your problem is you're trying to stand outside the system and declare a truth that you're not willing to live under. And that ain't going to work. Let me say it another way. Another way of looking at it is that Christians, if you look at Mark 4 and also Matthew, I believe, chapter 13, the parable of the sower and the word, the reality is Christians can be 30, 60, 100-fold fruitful Christians. The question with tithing and giving on any level that you choose is, how much fruit do you want to manifest? At some level, if you're a believer, you're going to be blessed. At some level, you're going to receive the blessing of Abraham upon your life in some way, shape, form, or fashion. But in this financial area, we and the majority of Christians in our generation, and what we have been reading to you from the Word of God, we believe there are certain financial principles that are really true, and God will use them to promote you and bless your life. Got it? If you choose to rebel against what he says, you can rationalize all you want to, but you're going to have to take the weight. So it doesn't mean you're not going to be saved. We're not excommunicating you from the kingdom. Hallelujah. We're not even saying you don't know Jesus. But I am going to say that you may not be a hundredfold fruit producing, blessed in every occasion, prospered in every situation Christian.